I'm Augustine Frizzell. I was the writer. I am the writer and director of Minor Setback.
And I'm Liz Franke, and I am a producer of Minor Setback.
So, I mean, first of all, tell me about this film. What was the inspiration?
I based it on my true life as a rambunctious teen. That's the main inspiration. I wanted to make something that represented like the type of teen that I was, which was not your traditional, you know, teenage movie.
So tell me about what goes on in the film.
So it's about a couple of girls. They're 16 years old and they work at a diner, and their one plan in life is just to get to the beach and have a day there. Mm-hmm. And then something goes wrong, and it's about the chaos that ensues, and you know what happens, and how they deal with it.
So, if it's based on your story, is it a little frightening to kind of talk about yourself, you know, in through film?
No, I think it's pretty therapeutic, actually. I think not only with this, but with other scripts that I write that are inspired by my real life. My upbringing wasn't necessarily easy or traditional, and so instead of looking back and having, you know, any sort of like victim mentality, instead I've kind of recreated those memories, if that makes sense, and kind of turned it into something, because it wasn't all bad, and I had some really fun times with my friends, and you know, all of our teenage years are unique to us, and so I wanted to kind of form it in a way that I could look back on it positively, and so it's actually been pretty helpful.
Yeah, and sometimes when you look back, I mean, in the moment when you're a teen, like everything's tragic and everything's like you know, magnified by 100.
Yeah.
But then you go back and look, and you're like, oh, it wasn't that bad. It was a little dramatic.
Exactly, and like, yeah, and I had really good friends, and we had a lot of fun, and you know, we have experiences that other people didn't have, and so that there's value there, and so yeah.
And what attracted you to the script and to the story?
I will say that I was an executive producer on her previous short film. Mm-hmm. I was a teenage girl. Mm-hmm. And so from the beginning, I was drawn to her vision. And I believe that Augustine is so talented, and she's just got such a fresh kind of perspective. So then when she was doing another short film, it's not that it's similar to the first one, but it's still young protagonists. Looking at it from a different angle. And so I think what stood out the most to me was that she was taking a story or a concept that could easily be very heavy and dramatic, and like she said, she was looking at it from a comedic standpoint. And I just don't think you see very many films out there in which you've got the protagonist is a teenage girl, mm-hmm. and it's handled in a comedic way instead of being all dramatic. You see tons of stuff in which it's teenage boys, yeah. and they might be getting into trouble or having, you know, chaos and so forth, that's handled in a comedic way, but never females. And I thought that was so cool. So I really wanted to help her bring her vision to life.
And tell me about the actors in your film. Where did you find them?
So the two lead girls, that was kind of the hardest part, and I knew before we made it that mm-hmm. I didn't want to make it until I found the perfect girls, mm-hmm. and so we did a lot of casting calls with Tisha Blood here in Dallas, mm-hmm. and saw a ton of people, and from all over, California, you know, all the markets, you know, and so we weren't finding anyone, and I mean, they were all great, and it wasn't that they weren't good actors, because there are so many great actors mm-hmm. here in Dallas and actresses, and so... but it was something really specific that they had to have, you know, as all scripts usually call for. Yeah. So I started looking online and just going through like YouTube videos and going through casting sites. And at one point I was on backstage.com mm-hmm. and just scrolling through like girls, you know, 16 I wanted someone 18 to 21 who looks younger. And so I just like was going through page mm-hmm. after page after page. And then one of the girls, Ashley Beckel, I saw her picture and I was like, oh, she's got an interesting look. And I clicked and she had a couple videos. And I thought, oh, she's got like this comedic thing going and she just looks right. And oh, please let her have a good audition.
Exactly.
And so I looked her up. I did a little stalking. I found her on like Twitter, I think, and like followed her, because you have to follow them on the thing. And wrote her a message, and I was like, hey, I'm making this film, and would you be interested in auditioning? And then she wrote back, and thank goodness, and did her first read, and it was just great. And it was a little off from what I was going for. And so I sent her like a page of notes, because she lived in Louisiana. Yeah. And so I sent her a page of notes. I was like, can you do it again? And she had the video like that. Like within a day, she'd like worked on the notes, mm-hmm. incorporated them, and sent back like a killer audition. Mm-hmm. I was like, oh, I think she might be the yeah. one. And so she turned out to be like perfect. And then Christina Burdett, she also, for some reason, I think she was out of town for the first several rounds of auditions, mm-hmm. and then had, like, towards the very end, Tisha sent out, like, one more call, and mm-hmm. at that point got her picture, and she looked really young, and so I was like, well, we'll see, let's bring her in, and when she came in, she was just perfect, and, like, the two of them together mm-hmm. just, was just great. That they're, like, the best part of the film, I think. Yeah. Everyone else was, like, someone we knew or, you know, through the audition process.
And so where did you guys film? You guys filmed here in
Yeah, Dallas, we shot half or? Of it here in Irving, mm. and then the other half in LA. I've moved to LA recently, and so we did like there's some beach stuff in it, so we did that there.
So okay, so you moved to LA. So yeah. what is the environment now for women? Because I know that it feels like things are starting to change with people complaining so much about the industry that there aren't enough women making films and there aren't enough people of color making films. So what have you experienced out there?
Well, you know, not really anything different than here. I think just because I'm not like actively, you know, going out and like having meetings or anything like yeah. that. But I think in general, just the attention to the matter is really helpful. Mm-hmm. And I think I think it's done nothing but like work towards making it better. And I know there are a lot of people that are actively doing their part. I know Ava DuVernay's making her series, and it's called Queen Sugar, and she has, I think, 12 episodes maybe. Every single one of them are directed by females. Mm-hmm. Every cast member almost is a person of color. And so it's stuff like that because the awareness is there, there's money being put towards it. And so that may not have been possible a few years back, just because nobody feels comfortable or feels safe to put money towards it. And so I think just the attention is really making a difference.
And what do you hope your story inspires people, or what do you want them to take from this film?
Well, from the film, I just want people to be entertained, I think. Like, yeah. I mean, I've noticed like it's either something people relate to or it's something they don't relate to. And yeah. I think, you know, coming from the place where I came from, which was we didn't have any money, we were high school dropouts, you know, we worked at a diner, we were doing drugs and just being really bad, I think some mm-hmm. people are like, oh yeah, that was kind of like what I was doing, maybe yeah. not exactly those things. And there are other people that are like, what? Like, where does this happen? So, I mean, bringing awareness to that, but also I think my main goal long term is that people who come from a place where I came from mm-hmm. or even, you know, worse conditions, become aware of the fact that it is possible to like tell your story and that there are people who want to hear your story. Mm-hmm. And so until these people who come from a place where I did or you know, from like a lower socioeconomic background or, you know, a place where art isn't so much of a part of their lives, that they would see that there is value in their story and that to write it and tell it is possible, because I think most people don't understand that that is a possibility and that we want to know what happens, we want to know what's going on, and we want to, their voices are important. So that's long term.
And I think that what was cool, or another thing that was drawn, I was drawn to the project about, was how the story in itself is not like an inspirational story, but I think Augustine kind of serves as being inspirational. Well, thanks. You know, like you said, that you're able to, you're, you know, you, it made you stronger, that all the things that happened to you when you were younger made you who you are today, and look at what you're doing. And so I think is really neat.
Thanks.
And what are you guys working on next?
The feature version of the story. So we're shooting that hopefully in August. Yeah.
What is it completely different from what you're telling, or I mean what is?
Well, it's fairly different. And to be frank and honest, we actually shot a full-length version a couple years ago, and it wasn't exactly what I wanted. And being that it was my first film, yeah. you know, like my feature-length film, mm-hmm. And as I edited it, even in the script process, I knew going in there were some things that I wasn't completely set mm-hmm. on, but I kind of did just because we were in a rush, and I thought maybe they'll work, and I was honestly like scared to take the script where I wanted to take it. I was playing it really safe, and so then those parts when we saw the footage, and or I saw the footage and I was editing it, just weren't my favorite, and I was like, I should have trusted myself in the script process. I should have been more secure in like what I wanted to say mm-hmm. and going like balls to the wall instead of like holding back. And so when I cut it, I was like, I don't think this is the right film yet, and so I cut it down to a short, which I really liked the short. And then went back to the script and made some changes, and that's the story that I'll tell. And it's a lot more authentic to what I wanted to say the first time, and so I'm really looking forward to.
Well, that's interesting that you used a short as like a tool to help you with the creative process to kind of.
Oh yeah, it's huge.
That's pretty interesting.
Mm-hmm. You learn so much, and shorts on their own are a fully complete piece of work, but. You also have that as a really affordable way of like gaining experience and just like trying new things. And so I love the short format, but I'm very excited about the future.
Well, we can't wait to see it when it comes to Diff.
So
Liz, what are you working on?
I'm also going to be producing the feature mm-hmm. and I'm really excited about that. And then I'm continuing to write and want to do another short film. I had a short here at TIFF last year and working on another one.
And producing, we produced two shorts for James Johnston this weekend, so hopefully they'll hear that next year
incredible.
Too. Yeah, they're really great.
So congratulations, you guys. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.